Hello everyone and welcome back to Palace Zoo, episode 10 already. Yes, episode 10. Oh, this is going pretty fast actually. Okay, this episode we are continuing with the overhaul of the habitats and the zoo and the general things here. So I'm really excited about that. We're basically polishing it up for now, and then we're basically on the halfway point of completing the zoo, I would say. Of course, it has been a lot of buildings and a bit less habitats, but now the focus is gonna lie a bit more on the animals for the most part then, and like the bigger enclosures with bigger animals, so I'm really looking forward to that. But yeah, what you're seeing here is I'm redoing this the camel enclosure building, because it was a bit weird, and I'm incorporating the feedback of people again, so I'm putting here some wooden wall here to close the area off a bit from the view of people, so that the camels have some private space too. And here's the animal doors, where they go outside and all of that stuff. Also, the look of the building is now a bit more diverse and less limestone and more actual brick would be more suitable for a building like this. And then the next piece of thing I did, someone commented that I should round the edges of the hedges, which is hard because we don't have any. Maybe we do have round hedges, but not the one I was looking for anyway. So what I did here, I was just placing cypress trees on the corners and the hard edges of the maze, so that it looks a bit more natural and wild. Okay, next thing already, I'm crossing off my list here. So the PFAS also need some private area, and that's what this circle is here. So I changed the glass to one-way glass. Had some trouble with it here, but pretty happy with how it is now. The PFAS have a quiet place to shut down a bit and rest. So I also had it hay everywhere in every enclosure. Basically, I made this a bit prettier. I made this building a bit more prettier, or at least more or less of a weird shape, because it was kind of a weird shape before, wasn't it? So yeah, it's now square for a bit, and also an animal door, even though, well, they're PFAS. I don't know, I just like the look of that door, so I'm using that a lot now. Next thing, I changed the fences and the barrier walls to what suits best for the animal, because some of them are really weird. They don't need that that concrete and limestone stuff. Oh yeah, next thing already on my list, deleting the solar panels here. I thought it was pretty funny to have them there, because then you can show the people that your mind is on the environment and stuff, but it's also really ugly, so I chose for the beauty this time. Next thing already, check on the list is the education boards. I don't like the screen on the stand, so I did some custom stuff in stone and I put those everywhere basically. Happy with how that looks. Okay, next thing already, I had like a fun list to go through this episode, which is pretty obvious I think at this point. So the flamingo habitat also was a bit weird. Not enough water, not deep enough or something. The building was I really dislike this building. So these buildings are now like a mix of the limestone and the brick, and I think it looks pretty cool. Definitely isn't as expensive as like copper roofs and stuff, so that's good. I also added these windows to give that like backstage feel, or like utilitarian feel. This episode is basically the same building design for the most of the buildings to have the same theme going on, but at the same time give it a bit more diversity with the previous limestone buildings that stood here. Some more feeding sacks here, sacks of feed I should say, and increase the water area so they can swim a bit more. And yeah, that's what flamingos do, right? They swim and stand in water. Yeah. So I added one feeding trough thing, and then people couldn't get to it, so I added like a little land bridge later. But yeah, I spent a bit less attention to the demands of the animals for now, and did what I liked aesthetically a bit more. I'm sure the animals realistically wouldn't mind that much. But in the management episode, when we're done with everything, building everything, I'm gonna perfect that a bit more. Oh yeah, and also a thing on my list, adding disabled parking areas, because, well, we need those, and it's 2020, so yeah, we need to go with the times. So yeah, the little cross section here is for the people to get out of their vehicle, and this is another blueprint by Mr. Domes, by the way, the disabled sign. Yeah, I did read it to tape here, walls, because apparently they can bite pretty hard and cut your fingers off. And we don't want that. So I added like a steel mesh fence for the parts where there isn't any water next to it. And also a bit of a private area for those animals too. Okay, next thing already. What a nice space. Okay. So, giraffes. Yeah, giraffes. Someone said like you should make like a little vet area and a staff facility there. And maybe some hay, some extra feed for the animals and stuff like that. So that's what I'm doing here, little circular building. No wait, that's square. It's square building with a extended roof thing. Yeah, same thing as before with the wall things. I think it works for this general area and gives a bit more life to it. Seems like it's actually used instead of just a habitat building alone. So yeah. So here I'm making a little area to put the thatch or hay or straw, whatever you call it, what the giraffes eat. Just a little storage area, a little sacks and ladders and stuff. Basically the same things. Yeah, the same things that plays everywhere. So little lights here. Yeah, so after this episode, I'm gonna build like one episode on the structure at the back of the gardens. And then later I'm adding more animals. Some people actually want to do like a sort of collab idea with me. So I'm excited to do that a bit. So I'm looking forward to that stuff. Oh yeah, next thing here on my list, the interior of the eating facilities, the reptile house. Yeah, that's it. So people said, hey, it's too white in there. It needs to be darker. So that's what I'm doing here. Feeling and make it a bit more tropical, mysterious, I guess. It just like the white didn't mix with the wood texture and all the Arctic stuff, so I deleted all the windows and I did a lot of work, but it pays off in the end. So also the trees on the the plants on the wall and all the vines and stuff looked a bit weird, out of place, so those are gone. Yeah, so the entire building is now made on stone from the inside. Is it real stone? I don't know. It's inside of a building, so probably not. No. Okay, and I changed the lights to black. Because there isn't light coming from the outside. Well, a bit maybe, but not that bright. So, yeah. I covered the white limestone things with wood. To give it like a bit more monochrome color palette, the building. Yeah, pretty fun doing this actually, because I'm happy with how it looks now. And I wasn't before, so that's fixed. Another thing not to worry about anymore. So since this is like the halfway point of the zoo pretty much, in terms of work, not size, I'm not sure. I did like a cool cinematic show video of like a couple of minutes at the end of this video. That shows the park, everything basically what we've built so far, and yeah, I'm actually really happy with how we're going with it so far. But yeah, it's still, again, if people have any cool ideas or feedback or there are things they think about, hey, that's wrong, that's not good, change that, then tell me so. Then, of course, we will fix that in a later episode. So you can really see the building coming together now. It's like a whole different aesthetic here. Oh yeah, I also forgot to put like information signs in the reptile house last episode. That's also a thing we added, including this TV here. I wish it was just like normal wooden signs or something instead of electronical. Oh yeah, okay, this is pretty much the last thing. I think there's a little backstage area at the entrance, because there was a gap here and I didn't want to fill it with woods, because we need like a fence and like that protects the park from the exit, or how do you say, like, you need a ticket to go in, so we need to fence off the park. And this helped with that. And also some more backstage areas here. The guns hurt, right? So there's a quarantine and a vet. and a research center here, and just general stupid stuff. Yeah, the building is very similar as the buildings we've made before, as you can see. But I'm happy with the end result of this area. Also, I did some more groundwork, or I shade like brickwork on the floor. So it just mixes really well now. Yeah, I'm happy, really happy with this episode actually. We have basically did everything, I fixed everything that was an issue before, and now I can just continue on with my plans for now and complete the zoo slowly but surely. I think like another a month or two and we'll be done with it. So I'm thinking, I'm not sure, but I'm thinking about doing a challenge episode, or the career. Either the career gameplay, like all the scenarios and stuff, or doing like a franchise zoo. I'm not sure which one yet, just say what you would prefer, and then I can do that too, because I really want to play this game a bit more instead of just building in it. I mean, the managed part is pretty fun, what I've heard, so yeah. This is basically finishing off the episode, this bit, some little forest area, so now you can really see that it's nearest completion, this entrance area, so I'm happy with that. Some lights, and then I think I did like a little border thing here. Yeah, but anyway. Oh no, we're not done yet, surprise. Okay, so yeah, I did some lighting here. Oh yeah, I forgot to light the big dome thing, which looks really cool in the dark. I also did a shot of it later. And this is, I completed the plaza here because we have four like arrow things basically coming from the center of the zoo. And I didn't build this one yet, so now that's there. Oh yeah, I also forgot about this thing. I built like a little bench area in the center to sit down. I didn't want to block the view of the building here. But yeah, okay, I hope you like it. So thanks for watching. Bye!